Muharram then. But of all of the ones who Mukhtar caught, of all of them, one in particular was the one who gave him the most happiness that he caught him. Because he had heard from Imam Zain al-Abidin how much the arrow from that particular one had hurt Ahlul Bayt salawatullah wa salamu alayhim. Al-Minhal narrates, he says, I entered upon Imam Zain al-Abidin when he was in Mecca. When I entered upon him, the Imam looked at me. He said to me, what is the news of Harmala bin Kahil? Imagine, Imam Zain al-Abidin asks, what is the news of Harmala bin Kahil? What do we hear about him? He said, he's still alive at the moment. Imam said, oh Allah, let him taste the heat of the fire. Yes? And not just Har al-Nar, Har al-Hadid as well. The heat of that metal as well. Which metal? Because when they took the neck of the baby, that arrow that they used was an arrow that you cut the neck of a camel with. I ask you, my dear brothers and sisters, wherever you may be in the world, those of you especially who have children, how delicate is the neck of a child? Number one, how delicate is the neck of a baby? But number two, a camel, you use an arrow for a camel. A camel can contain thirst for a long time. That baby had been without water for a certain period of time. So Imam Zain al-Abidin alayhi salam says to Minhal, what's the news? He says to him, he's still alive. Minhal says, I went to Kufa. He says, when I entered Kufa, at the moment that I entered, I saw everybody. I asked, where is Mukhtar al-Thaqafi? What is he doing? Tell us. They said to him that Mukhtar al-Thaqafi has just caught Harmala bin Kahil. Allahu Akbar. He has just caught who? Harmala bin Kahil. That moment in Minhal said, I went to Sahat Kunasa. Sahat Kunasa was a place where people would gather, where people would be executed. He said, I went towards there and I saw the court case of Harmala bin Kahil. Many times people ask us, how do we know what took place? Again, here is an example. When Mukhtar was in front of Harmala bin Kahil, he had asked him a number of questions. And these questions would be questions that we remember until today. What did he ask him? He asked him about what happened on the 10th of Muharram. He answered him one by one. I'll come to each answer shortly. But after having executed him, you found that Mukhtar saw al-Minhal. He looked at him, having heard that Mukhtar had killed Harmala and had executed him. At that moment, Minhal looked and he said, Subhanallah. Al-Mukhtar al-Thaqafi looked at him. He said, Subhanallah is normally a good thing to say, but why do you say it? He said, because I was just with Imam Zain al-Abidin alayhi salam. And when he asked me about Harmala bin Kahil in particular. When he asked me, I then saw him read a dua, oh Allah, let him taste the fire, let him taste the metal. I've just seen the dua accepted. Mukhtar al-Thaqafi went down in sujood, thanking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that he had been mentioned in the dua of the Imam. When al-Minhal told Imam Zain al-Abidin alayhi salam, this definitely brought happiness towards the Imam, that Harmala bin Kahil had finally been avenged. But when he what he had done, it had broken the heart of Imam Zain al-Abidin. Why? Because Mukhtar al-Thaqafi asked Harmala bin Kahil the questions. He said to him, on the 10th of Muharram, how many arrows did you shoot? The reply came that I shot 4 arrows on the 10th of Muharram. These 4, whenever we hear about them, they break our hearts. Yes? What was the 4 arrows? He said the first Yes, arrow I shot on the right eye of Abu al-Fadl al-Abbas when he had lost his right and his left arm. Abu al-Fadl had lost his right arm. He had lost his left arm. He was on the horse. He says that I saw that he was trying to return back towards the tent. Then all of a sudden when he was returning, I shot his right eye. He said, normally when someone falls from their horse, they fall with their arms in front of them, except Abbas, when he fell from his horse, he had no arms to support him. He then looked at him, he said to him, how about the second arrow? He said to him, the second arrow I shot on Abdullah, the son of Imam al-Hasan alayhi salam. Imam al-Hussein was lying on the ground. He looked like a hedgehog from the amount of arrows on his body. He says that at that moment, we were about to shoot his heart. I saw this young boy running out of the tent, and I saw his auntie Zainab calling him, come back to me. He said, I saw him turn around to his aunt, and he said to her, oh my auntie, how can I come back? And my uncle Abu Abdullah is alone where he is. So he says, I saw him sit by his uncle. He looked towards his uncle. He smiled at his uncle. At that moment, someone came towards him and killed him after I had shot him. That was the second arrow. How about the third arrow? This one I leave with you. Imagine when Imam Zain al-Abidin alayhi salam says, this one hurt us the most. How much did it hurt them? He said, the third arrow I shot on the neck of the six-month-old baby. He said, the moment I shot him, he flapped his hands like a bird flaps its wings. He said, I saw Abu Abdullah carry the blood from under the neck of his baby. He said, then after that, I saw Hussein return to his tent and come back and return and come back. We called out, Hussein, what's wrong with you? Why don't you return? He said, I don't know how to tell her mother that her baby's neck has been cut in half. Imam Zain al-Abidin, no doubt, the baby remained in his conscience forever. That was his baby brother that he kept on thinking about. And that's why it's no surprise when Imam Zain al-Abidin returned the head of Abu Abdullah towards his body. When he returned the head towards the body, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, there was a karama for Imam al-Hussein. What was it? The karama was that he spoke when the head returned back to the body. And what did he say? All of you have heard these lines. The baby placed the baby on my chest. And his neck placed his neck on my neck. Don't you know, my son Ali, don't you know that the heat of that arrow hurts us until today? Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un. وسيعلم الذين ظلموا أي منقلب ينقلبون واللعنة الدائم على القوم الظالمين. My dear brothers and sisters, raise your hands wherever you may be. Ya Allah, raise us with Muhammad and Al Muhammad. Allow us to receive the intercession of Imam Zain al-Abidin alayhi salam. Allow us the ziyara to Jannat al-Baqi'. Allow us to be next to his grave. For the originators of this majlis, Ya Allah, bless them with the intercession of Muhammad and Al Muhammad. In honor of our grand marja, may Allah bless his soul, Ayatullah al-Khoi, and his beloved sons. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless them and allow them to receive the intercession of Imam Zain al-Abidin alayhi salam. We pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with a surah al-Fatiha in their honor and the honor of all of our marhumin. But before it, wherever you may be, the loudest of your salawat. Allah.